Alors on dort. Alors on dort.
Guy named Bernie Young. I know for a fact that Bernie Young used my American Express card to hire an attorney to file a petition against me. That was done with my American Express card. Bernie Young, you're no good. And this is not fair at all, you know? And then there's this person.
Welcome back, Truth Confederacy. Welcome to another pile of bullshit that we're gonna wade through. Now, if you've seen it, I saw it on another YouTube creator's channel commenting about it. This clip that was at the beginning of Wendy Williams, they're saying that she's off the wheels on drugs and alcohol. And now, while I don't doubt that that is true, don't mistake what I'm saying here. I'm not saying she's not. However, I worked in the medical field for many years, and I've seen people from many different types of drugs, mixing drugs. I've seen them in conditions such as coming down all the way up to being in a coma, having machines do their daily functions for them so they're still alive. But never in my days have I ever seen someone's eyes and face and neck contort to the capacity that hers did in this video clip. If you go back and watch that again and pay attention, her eye literally bugs out of its socket and then like snaps right back in her head. That's some low-level demon shit, in my opinion. You know, and another thing is when someone is got a, you know, people that's on certain types of drugs will get tics, like, you know, running their jaw or you know, rolling their tongue or stuff like that. They're not aware that they're doing that. She was aware of her face contortion because she kept trying to cover it up with the turtleneck. So that, to me, says right there, that wasn't a drug-fueled contortion. That I've literally, and I'm not, I've seen a lot in the supernatural world, but not a lot have I seen that's really freaked me out to the point that I had to completely turn the video off. But I did hers. There's one part in the video that her eye, I just, kids, I can't. So the conspiracy theorist in me says, self, this ain't someone that's just simply on drugs. This is not just simply a drug-fueled rant about someone stealing her credit card and using it to file a lawsuit against her. Which, by the way, side note, that's the biggest and best troll move to date that I've seen. Who takes someone's card and makes it a payment to make a lawsuit against them with their own money? That is, I'm sorry, Wendy. I'm sorry. You set yourself up for that one, demon. So today I figured that I would put my conspiracy feelings to the test, do a little reading, ask a few questions, get a little answers. You know how we do. We get downs like that. So I've got a couple questions that I'm going to throw out there and see what the cards bring back. Eight. Here we go. And by the way, who is her publicist to let her let her have free reign access over whatever platform she put that on? That was some worthwhile stuff. Okay, first question. The circumstances of her bizarre behavior. Is it simply drug-related? Okay. Wendy Williams' state of mind. Say, forces or influences either behind her or surrounding her. And for all you out there who believe in reptilians, the truth behind her biological makeup. And last but not least, let's move this up a little. The capability of Wendy Williams when it comes to harm to herself or others. Stair-step it down, baby. Alrighty. First card is going to be the circumstances behind Wendy's bizarre behavior. That's going to be the Five of Pentacles reversed. Five of Pentacles reversed represents illnesses improving. It's recovering from problems, addiction issues. It's showing someone who has recovered and improved in order to rebuild their security and stability. It indicates letting go of people that are toxic to you. What it looks like here is Wendy has improved and recovered. So I don't think she's on drugs right now, so to speak. I think that our friend Wendy here is trying to escape or trying to break free of the powers that be that's over Hollywood or, you know, the elite. So it boils down to pretty much what they do is they strap on the narrative that you're crazy, you're on drugs, just like what they're doing to Kanye West right now. Convincing the public or the media that pushing the agenda that you're crazy, you're on drugs, you know, you're not stable, and that way whenever you suicide, like Jeffrey Epstein, you know, people's not going to be questioning that or, you know, looking at that in any type of suspicion. It's just going to be assumed that that's the path that you follow if you're on drugs and crazy and have this mental illness and stuff. Now, the next card is going to show Wendy's state of mind. That's the Three of Wands. That's a card of representation of freedom, foresight, forward planning, and growth. So, yeah, she's trying to cut free of that toxic environment she's been surrounding herself in. The next card is going to be the forces or influences behind her behavior or around her behavior. It's going to be the Hanged Man reversed. That's being impulsive. Feelings or changes that you're trying to avoid, but you know that need to be made. And you're avoiding these because it's out of fear, which really directly correlates back to trying to break free of that toxicity here. This whole thing about signing, you know, a contract in blood and stuff, that's for real. It may not be as literal as, you know, you sell your soul to the devil. A lot of these people have no soul, because that's another subject for another story, another day. But, you know, they put the fear of them right back on them. They have them in jail, have them in mental institutions, mind control, have an agenda against them. So there's fear there. I mean, because, you know, nobody's going to be on your side. You know, they're all but for one team. So now the next one is going to show us the biological makeup, and that's the King of Swords. King of Swords is a male aspected card. I knew it! I knew Wendy Williams was a male. I knew it. So, my friends, Wendy is probably a Lenny. There you go. You heard it here first. Now, our last card is going to show her harm capability. That's what she's capable of when it comes to harm to herself or others. Now, the Queen of Swords reversed is a nasty and vicious female, which is what the role she plays. But the worst that this one will do is spreads malicious gossip. She's obsessive and controlling, a liar, a cheater, disloyal, and deceitful. So, there's no physical harm capability here. So, in hindsight, it looks like that she's on drugs and she's crazy and she's ranting and raving, which that was an impulsive decision to do. But in reality, Wendy or Lenny, whichever you want to call her, or see her, or whatever pronoun that she goes by, is, of course, mixed up with the elite. She's the elite's property, belongs to the elite. And they've let her, you know, that also answers my question at the beginning of the video when I said, where was her publicist? Why did they allow this to go through? Because it pushes the narrative. She's crazy. She's on drugs. She's unpredictable. you know, that way. Look for Wendy Williams to be either committed to a psych ward for a mental health break, or I don't want to think anything more sinister is going to happen at this time. I don't know, but I don't want to feel like that. But on up to, it could be as severe as a suicide or a concocted story of her taking someone else's life and then taking her own. So that's what you need to look for. But this is all a elite constructed narrative. All right, guys. Thank you for joining me for this read. Have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye now.
Throw your hands in the sky right now. Alone.